Hello.
Hello.
We're here doing another Jackbox stream. It's Friday night Jackbox.
Yep, and I'm...
Jax.
I'm still going through some issues.
Yeah, Jack's on some back medications, so...
I need to go to a chiropractor.
Yeah, it's not as bad as it was. Well, I'm sure we'll just be repeating ourselves when we add people. Let's get people in the call. We have Grimmix joining us again.
Expect me to be stoic this stream.
Yeah. Oh, whoops. Oh, right. Are you going to be... How are we... I didn't think how we're going to do this with you. Do you have headphones?
Oh, yeah. Shit. How we did it last time is I just used Skype on my computer. It's fine.
Jack doesn't care about anything.
No, not really.
I'll get the splitter. Be right back.
Okay.
Sorry.
Where'd it go? There it is. Beer was at home. He just knocked the phone out of my hand accidentally. Oh, is that,
Sorry, Grimmix, we can't hear you yet. If you've picked up, he hasn't picked up.
Oh, this is good.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Who else do we got? We got Gleam is joining us.
Yep.
I'm just gonna add everyone to the call. And Moro
joining us.
Moro has not responded. We have Reifiui again.
We so far are aliens for.
Hi Gleam, we can't hear you just yet. Okay, there. Okay. It's gonna be tight.
Alright.
Okay, we can hear now.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, and then... Contact can only receive IMs.
They've been banned from Skype. Violated their terms of service, they did.
Hello, is anyone there?
Hi.
Oh, there he is. There's Reifiui, at least. We got someone.
Hello.
Let me try adding, Grimmix one more time. Hello?
Hello, there.
Okay, we got him. There we go.
Hello.
And now let me add my friend here.
Yeah. Grimmix has a plus one.
His name is Jeff.
Okay.
We'll see him. Wait, it's not letting me add him.
Here, let me, What's it saying? Is it not?
I go to add to the call and it just does nothing.
Okay.
Maybe because I'm not the host? You have to be the host to add people?
I should still be able to add him, like, indirectly.
Oh, wait, you can see his name on there?
Normally I would be able to, but I can't.
Okay, well, here, I'm just going to send you his name. Maybe you can add him. I'll let him know that you're adding him.
Okay.
What's your, Oh, you're just Xelrog. Okay, let's see. And he's in ski something. Hold on. Uh, Yeah, the location under his name will say Ski something, United States of America.
Okay. I think this might be it, perhaps?
S-K-E-E something.
I think it's S-E-E-K. I think
Yeah. Something like that.
Come on, Jeff. Where are you? There we go.
There.
Except I can't add him to the call for some reason. Let me try from the call. Maybe this will. There we go. Okay.
There we go.
We have him. Hello, Jeff.
Hello.
Hey, there you are.
Hi.
All right. Is there more coming, or is it just
Just us for now. People will be able to join from the stream if they want to.
All right. Oh, you're streaming.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks for the warning.
Oh, sorry, were you not aware?
Yeah. Nah, it's all right.
Yeah, I would pretty much stream most everything I play of late. Whatever. And it was the last one was streamed, if you're also not aware. Okay, Jackbox. Here we are. Okay. And I got a screen share with you guys.
I'm still here. I'm just...
Yeah, Jack's here.
I'm preparing for the match.
Oh, can you also link the site? Because I don't have it saved.
Jackbox.tv.
Okay, simple enough. So, Jeff, make sure you go to that Jackbox.tv, you said? All right.
In your browser. Okay, I think I'm all set. I've got a really obtuse setup me and Jack have going on right now.
I'm having to be on my side because of my back.
Yeah. Jack is half here.
You don't have a room set up yet, right? No code?
No, I am just doing so now. You guys can see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Look here. Okay, so what were you wanted to start with Quiplash, Jack?
Did I?
Did I?
I think you did. You never asked me what I wanted to start with. Don't foist your shit on me. Start with whatever you want.
Do you guys have a preference?
Fibbage.
Hey, Fibbage? Jack! Okay. Did you say you wanted to do Quiplash? No!
I don't have Quiplash.
Oh, Quiplash is fun, though. We should totally
do it. Hey. We did Quiplash.
Stop her.
Stop her?
No, I'm sorry. I'm talking to my wife about my daughter here. She's,
Okay. Room code is MQJG.
You have a lot of... Hold on. Okay, then.
I'm here. Oh, who started?
I didn't do anything.
Guess who didn't get in.
I'm not even in the room.
Okay, well, someone hit what they weren't supposed to hit. You weren't supposed to start the game yet. Unfortunately, this game is kind of dumb in that it won't give the host computer control over when to start. It gives whoever joins the room first, so someone can accidentally start it before everyone's in.
Wow.
So, if you get in first, please wait for instruction to hit start. Okay, I think I made it first, except I know I'm in the third spot. That's weird. Okay, whatever. So, I think Gleam is in the first position, and... Unless it doesn't look like there's anyone that
I think I'm in, but I can't see myself. That's weird.
Trollocks. So
I'm. Did you just sound?
Oh, I have to do that.
Trelax is Jeff.
Okay, Trelax, so yeah, we're just missing Reifiui, and then that's everyone. So you can just go ahead and start, Reifiui.
Okay.
Here we go.
There we go. All right, we got a six-player game. Now you guys aren't going to be able to hear the. Welcome to Fibbage. This is on stream. The narrator in the background, but you guys won't be able to hear the audio. So anyone? I'll just give my fabulous narration.
It's a sad day for us.
Yes. That's okay. It's incentive to watch the stream later.
I can hear it.
Oh, yeah, Jack can hear it. Jack's got an edge.
Yeah. I can play with my eyes closed.
Hey, Jack, how's your back, bro?
Not good. I'm basically slanting.
You ever go to Taco Bell and you get those like, cinnamon twists? It's kind of like that.
Pretty much that, yes.
Damn.
Yeah.
I like cinnamon twists, though.
They are delicious.
Now you just ruined them for me.
Well, I mean, just thinking your back is a cinnamon. Well, yeah.
Gleam just started working at Taco Bell. Good to know.
So you've got,
choose a word, Jack.
So you got Xelrog. Yeah. So you got Xelrog licking your back every now and then.
You guys should learn more about this country.
Okay.
Finland.
It's pretty good metal scene.
Also defeated the Russians.
If for some reason you're good at throwing blank, then you should train to enter the annual World Championships in Savonlinna, Finland, and see if you can throw one the farthest. So type in something that you think people will believe, that will fool people. A good lie. You get points for people guessing your lie, and you also get points for later guessing the truth.
I put down weapons grade uranium. Don't tell anyone.
I think they
uranium or geranium? Geraniums are plants.
If you're good at throwing bowling balls, good at throwing mobile phones, at trees, throwing parties, throwing bricks, throwing your own children, or throwing horseshoes. How do you throw a party the farthest?
The party the farthest? Yeah, you know, how far can you go? Okay, let's take a look. Like,
you gotta party pretty hardy.
Will the house get burned down?
Horseshoes was Grimmix's lie.
Good job.
Grimmix or Dale, do you care?
I don't care.
Bricks? Oh, that fooled me. That was Reifiui's.
Oh.
It was bricks or bowling balls.
What did I... But
maybe it's mobile phones.
It seems just the kind of thing to be true. Yes!
Yep, that's Jax.
Oh, man. Well, it's because that's the only one that really made sense, because people throw their mobile phones in anger all the time.
It could have been your own children. They have midget throwing
Who
competitions.
Who does that in Finland? I've never heard of that shit happening. You know what they do?
We have, dwarf bowling in American bars.
Well, that sounds like a kind of thing that would exist, and I would probably get that Fibbage question, too.
Reifiui, choose a category. Execution.
Oh, gosh.
Good choice. Okay, here's the question. The last words that convicted murderer Robert Charles Comer spoke before his execution by lethal injection were not all that poignant, but they were unique. His last two words were simply blank.
Type in your lies now.
I'm hoping. Well, I kind of forget what mine was last time.
Yeah.
Okay, where's the
last two words were I hate. The end. Jesus wept. My B. Go Raiders. Do it, or that's sharp. There are some good ones here. Go Raiders. Go Raiders!
Oh my god, I'm so tempted for that one. I hate.
Alright, who picked watch?
The end.
That's so corny.
That was Gleam's.
That's like an end of Hollywood movie line. The end.
The end of a poem reading. That sharp was Grimmix's.
Who's saying that?
That was Reifiui.
I thought it was just stupid enough to be true.
Do it! Hit me! Oh, that was Jeff's.
Oh, that was... I chose that one too. Was it seriously?
Okay.
Was it seriously go Raiders? Fuck! I wanted
really?
It! Oh man!
Are you kidding me?
Why are we laughing? That's horrible!
I'm sure that encouraged them. I'm sure they were happy to know he was on their side.
You know, nobody's on their... Not even
it's like
Florida
that,
gives a shit about the Raiders.
It's like that episode of South Park where the KKK is like, hey guys, let's support the one that we don't want because we know everyone's going to vote against us.
Trelex, choose word.
Okay, Jeff's turn.
Well, we ain't waiting
oh,
forever.
Too late. Yeah, you don't have a lot of time for that. British, good choice anyway.
Last time I missed it because I was trying to actually click the screen that I was
going to. Oh, okay, that's fancy graphics. Road trip! According to a recent survey conducted by Professor Mark Mayo something of University College London, your average British person has no clue how to properly blank.
Input your lies now.
Ah, I didn't think I got a good one.
I don't have any idea.
I got... This is a difficult one.
Your average British person has no clue how to properly swear, how to properly floss, how to properly get away with murder, how to properly make tea, how to properly cook, how to properly ride a bike, or properly snorkel.
Oh my god, is that actually gonna be it?
What, snorkel?
It has to be that one, because the other one's just impossible. Okay. The other one is blasphemy!
How to properly snorkel was...
Oh, Sly. Really? Oh my god! It really is that one?
That was Jeff Sly.
Prepare to be fucking shocked!
Properly ride a bike was the game's lie. How to properly make tea, was that it? Yep, I got it.
Yes!
Fucking, how come they don't know how to make...
Because stereotypes aren't true, Jack.
I know about a country turns out to be untrue.
No response, huh?
I'm at a loss for words. I fell for the trap.
Alright. Jeff and Grimmix in the lead. People liked floss. Alright, round two.
Oh my god, round one felt like it took hours.
Double points.
And remember to use your defibrillator if you need a little jolt of help. Use it in round two or lose it.
Alright, choose a word, Grimmix. Wendy's. Eat fresh. Now that's Subway.
Okay, here's the question.
Wendy's doesn't have a jingle, does it?
In
2005, a man in Manchester, New Hampshire was charged with stealing from a Wendy's. Interestingly, the man's name was blank. The man's name was Ronald McDonald, was Dave Thomas, Bob, disappointing, I know, was Carl, was Burger, was John Carl's Jr., was Wendy.
I know which one it is because I entered the truth, and I'm like, Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, I have an idea. I think I know.
Alright, let's see what everybody picked.
The man's name was Burger. Sorry, Reifiui, that was Gleam's line. Good effort. John Carl's Jr. was my lie. Thanks, Gleam.
That's fancy. I was, like
John Carl's Space Marine. Dave Thomas. What does that have to do with anything?
That's just a name.
Dave Thomas was the founder of Wendy's.
Oh, okay. Ronald McDonald, was that it?
Yeah.
Yep, that was it.
I had a feeling that was the truth, but...
Well, it's like, it's ironic.
For some reason, I thought Burger was a better answer.
Nobody went for Wendy,
It was too obvious.
His name was Taco Bell.
So you've seen this question before, Jack?
I have not. I just...
I think I read it in, like, a trivia book somewhere.
I just wanted to put Ronald McDonald in as my lie. And
the newbie is winning.
Me.
Yep, Jeff's in the lead. Right, okay, Gleam.
Armpits.
Smuggle.
Smuggler.
Okay, here's the question.
In 2013, a Chinese traveler at the Guangzhou Baiyun International Airport tried to smuggle his pet turtle aboard his flight by disguising it as blank. I have no idea how badly I mispronounced that.
Confucius says, man who stands on toilet is high on
pot. I was trying to think of a Koopa joke, but...
I couldn't.
Disguising it as an ashtray, as a hat, as a hamburger, as King Bowser, as his wife, as a helmet, or as a toaster.
Oh my god.
A lot of possibilities.
Probably.
Did we really need a hat and a helmet?
Yeah, you fancily block bullets to the head.
An ashtray was my lie.
That doesn't mean you would think of turtles as like... You think
well, yeah, that's what they're good for after they die.
Well...
A hat. Was Grimmix's lie.
I mean...
A helmet.
Who the fuck
I have a funny feeling it's gonna be his wife.
Nope, that was Jeff. I would believe it. No, we're married, I swear, legally. As a hamburger. Ronald McDonald strikes again.
No, think about it.
Was that? But I didn't want to get two times.
Did he just like take the turtle and wrap it in a Wendy's burger wrapper?
Yeah, or you put it in between the bun. If the legs stick in, you don't notice it. That's what
turtles
I was thinking.
Turtles can be big, man.
What was it you told me? We were driving the other day.
Yeah, small turtle, yeah.
And I told you my reason for not running over roadkill was that the ribs can pop your tires.
Yes!
And you said that's so brutally pragmatic.
That's
which is one way to describe me.
Okay, here's the question.
For the low fee of $35,000, Swiss company Erfolgswell will find a completely unique, one-of-a-kind blank for your baby.
Type in your lies now.
All right.
I got nothing.
Sad.
A one-of-a-kind pacifier, a one-of-a-kind gimp suit, a one-of-a-time Grimmix suit, a one-of-a-kind blender, a one-of-a-kind cradle, a one-of-a-kind name, or a one-of-a-kind Zanpakuto.
hell is a Zam?
Oh, whoops!
That's anime.
Yeah.
From,
a little bit of a stretch.
Right, Bleach.
Indeed.
You are correct.
A Grimmix suit?
Really? My thumb slipped.
And you actually chose it?
My thumb slipped. I was aiming for Grimmix.
A pacifier? Was Grimmix's lie. Good lie.
That's a pretty good one.
A one-of-a-kind cradle? Was Gleam's lie.
I think it was a name.
I think that's what I guessed.
Please be the truth.
Yes!
Yes!
I will name my child Sephiroth!
If there's one thing you can trust a company called Air Foxville to do, it's name things.
Air Foxville, that's how it's pronounced!
Okay.
The name is just 12 A's.
I mean, if no one else has it, they've done their job.
How the fuck would you pronounce a name with 12 A's?
Ah! It's like Moonbase Alpha.
Hey. No, I wanted to name him A. Just A, but the button got stuck.
Final fibbage.
Is that a jackalope?
That is a jackalope.
It is a jackalope. Good
luck. All right, triple points. The only round that matters. And only one prompt this time. Your final fibbage question. The name of the secret menu item at McDonald's created by swapping out the regular beef patties in a Big Mac for two quarter-pound patties.
Fuck, I feel like I should know this.
I've heard this before, but I don't remember it. Maybe if I see it.
Oh man,
a few more seconds, guys.
I love secret menu items, just the whole concept of it. Just
5 seconds.
Food hacking.
I'm not even trying, does that just can't?
No ideas. Out of time. The artery clogger. Maczilla, quarter pounder stack, McGangbang, McBigger, Beef Supreme, or McKinley Mac.
Jeez, these are all really good.
Hi, over me, McKinley Mac.
Okay, what did everyone pick?
Alright. Beef Supreme was Jeff's lie. You guys keep guessing each other's lies.
Come on. Oh.
The artery clogger was my lie.
I think it's McGangbang, actually.
Maczilla. Oh, that was. They're a lie.
It makes me think of mac and cheese.
Yeah. McBigger was Gleam's lie. I don't think I won, guys. Quarter pounder stack. Was that it? Nope,
no!
That was Grimmix's lie. What was it? Did no one guess it?
It was McGangbang. I'm telling you.
It was,
oh,
it was McKinley Mac.
What?
Oh.
What the fuck is that name?
Oh,
fuck, name somebody like this.
McKinley Mac, it's probably McKinley because the mountain.
Okay.
Stupid like
so
that.
It's Big Mac that originated in McKinley, where the beaches grew plenty.
Oh, Gorlex has been defeated.
Damn it!
Dale and Jeff dominating. And the thumbs cup goes to Jack.
Yay.
See, you're here enough. Alright.
So what is this Quib one you were looking at earlier?
We
Did
played
play
Quiplash
last,
time. We went through all the major ones, so we can do that again. That was the one that was improv, that you came up with a funny answer and then you'd vote between the two.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, I remember now.
I think it's the one with the most replay value of them, because you type in answers.
Right.
Yeah.
Alright, the code is QBQN.
Well, you type in answers for Fibbage, too, though, to be fair.
Yeah, true, but you have prompts that are given, and once you know the truth to those prompts...
Fibbages are fact-based, whereas Quiplashes are opinion-based.
Yeah.
Oh, do I have to re-enter? Oh.
Mick Eagle Pants is the first one in, so please don't start until everyone's in.
Who's McGigglepant?
I don't know. Gleam is in, so that's everyone who's here last time. It still doesn't look like any from the chat's joining. So
it's got to be Jeff McGigglepant. Yeah.
I think the gang's all here. I'm Xelrog.
We all here?
Yep. You are clear to start.
Jack, as you can see, is here.
All right. So you're going to be given 90 seconds to come up with your whatever you think is the funniest response you can come up with.
For two prompts.
To two prompts. So 90 seconds, two prompts. And after that, it'll pit two people's answers to the same prompt together, and we'll vote on which one we think is funnier. So this one is purely going for laughs.
Bring it on. Score based on the
percentage of points you answer. Plus, there are winner's bonuses at stake. Go!
Okay, 90 seconds, on the clock.
What's the... Oh.
All right. Those are, I actually had some easy ones. I got through that.
Oh, I forgot how to do this. Now I remember.
How much time do I got left?
42 seconds. Of all people, Jack asks that. He just has to look up and he can see the screen in real time.
I couldn't find.
Yeah, but it takes him 40 seconds to look up and see the screen. Remember, his back looks like.
Well, there's a slight delay for you guys because it's being, you know, streamed on Skype.
Like, my back is literally crooked. Like, if I stand straight up. I can't stand straight up because it bends one way.
I don't actually have the Skype chat visible, okay, so if you're saying anything, Gleam, you might want to post it in the stream chat.
I screwed this up.
What those bolts in Frankenstein's neck are for? Keep his brain juices in, or better reception.
Okay, everyone, vote for your favorite.
So there's really only one choice for that answer.
Yeah, I think everyone went to that side. Good job, Gleam.
Yeah, I knew that was pretty terrible.
You think Frankenstein has Wi-Fi?
Oh, he probably, motherfucker probably invented Wi-Fi.
He was an intelligent dude in the novel.
Yeah.
The terrible fate of the snowman Olaf in a director's cut of Frozen. He found his parents in an ice cream truck, or melted.
Director's cut? They just don't cut to him being surviving. Wait.
His was actually supposed to be the tragic death that, like, was the climax of the movie.
The other answer was really cool, too, because it implies... Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a much better answer, because that implies his parents were cannibals.
Yeah.
Like, cannibal Holocaust style, just eat.
Or they were, like, a product in the ice cream truck.
Oh.
I assumed was what it meant. What, you thought they were the ice cream snowmen?
Yeah, they're just selling ice cream.
Something fun to scream when you win a game of bingo other than bingo. Bullseye, or the prophecy has been fulfilled!
Fuck yeah! I would play a game called The Prophecy Has Been Fulfilled. That being said, that's not my prompt answer, so I shouldn't have said that.
Yay! Yeah.
I blanked out on that one. I'm like, what the fuck do I put?
99999! You guys can't hear it, that's what my character said.
Your character is Hitler?
Apparently. I'm like green blob Hitler. An image that would make the Sistine Chapel ceiling look more badass. Two clowns fighting with giant fish, or Jesus on a motorcycle.
Fuck yes!
Fight to the death, Zelly. Okay. That's Gloom's comment.
Sistine Chapel more bad.
This has been a very one-sided round.
Yeah.
Vroom vroom. I am always with you, my son of anarchy.
Little do we know, we've actually been fighting stand-up comedians. They excel at any kind of humor-based task. We might as well have not even been trying.
There hasn't been a tie yet. What you hope the Mars rover finds. The end of Five Nights at Freddy's, or weed. Weed photosynthesizes, right? Could you use that to, like, create air on Mars?
Oh my god, wait a minute. It fuck.
Really, really smelly air. Yep, people like weed. Short, sweet, and to the point.
I'm on the board, finally.
I do appreciate the jab at Five Nights at Freddy's, though.
Five Nights at... Is it finally ended?
I don't. They say it's end, and then another one comes out. The worst thing to wear to your court trial. Hannibal Lecter cosplay, or the jacket you stole and are on trial for.
Both of those are pretty bad.
They're both are good. Both are really good.
The second one, the jacket you stole and are on trial for, that one's actually happened in court.
It was boots. The guy stole boots and wore them to the trial for the boots.
Navy
he stole.
Sailor's outfit.
Oh, there was another case.
And I had the Navy sailor's name in the tag.
I seem to get a quiplash.
Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me.
That's the Jesus. Movie.
Don't start that shit, man.
Seriously.
I got a buddy of mine who's in Tennessee who could do the voice, and he used to come on to TeamSpeak or something and put the music on, like Brand New People, and he'd start doing that, and then he'd leave, and the people would be like...
On camera, obviously, right?
No, but he would play the sound, and he would do the voice. Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me so hard. And then he'd leave, and they'd be like... What the fuck was that? Because he put the music, the background music. He had
okay,
the background
two
music.
More prompts, 90 seconds. Can you imagine
Jay,
people
Jay
who
did
don't
that on
get
that
the
movie
reference?
Too, the Jay and Silent Bob movie.
Well, this is a creepy thing.
Oh, no. It was Clerks 2. It was Clerks 2 he did that.
Yeah. Well, it's like... Man.
Oh my god, I have no idea for that one.
Shit, what were you... Oh man, I was gonna say something, then I forgot it. Shit.
Fuck, I have no idea.
Forty-five seconds. I'm stuck on my second one.
I got both of them. I've managed to fulfill the prophecy.
Oh my god, I have nothing. I have nothing that sounds even remotely good. Oh my god. Can I just skip one question and go to the next?
Nope.
Just put down anything for...
20 seconds.
Anything is better than nothing, because anything allows you a chance to get pity points.
Gleam says his question sucked. 10 seconds.
Anything, guys. Literally, just type that. Type in words, letters. 2, 1, and we're gonna be down.
I was about to type a really good answer for that second one, but I was stuck at the first one. Ah!
The name of a new cologne inspired by celebrity chef Guy Fieri!
Oh, fuck.
Smelly giggles with a splash, or I'm depressed! There ain't no psychologist in Flavortown!
Only more spices.
I'm probably creating some bias by playing these up.
That was my shitty filler answer, and I won with it.
Because Guy Fieri is so Guy Fieri, it's just funny to imagine him depressed all the time.
Remember,
I'm dying inside! The least romantic place to propose marriage. Abortion clinic. Or...
Oh, damn it!
I could...
Stop, I damn, I would have kicked your ass!
I didn't have the time to type my answer because I took 10 hours to find out I'm depressed.
At least you won with that.
Abortion clinic! Oh, fuck you to just go there!
That's hard to beat
anyways.
The other
guy was too stunned to respond.
A good use for toenail clippings. A dinner party necklace, or ice cream sprinkles for people you don't like.
Dinner party necklace is like Texas Chainsaw Massacre shit. Like, that's not even creepy, that's just weird. Like, you see, like, this killer wear it to the table, you're not thinking, oh crap, this guy's a psycho, you're thinking,
yay!
Fuck, toenails?
Alright, what's next?
Coming up next.
The futuristic invention you can't wait to see exists. Sex bots. Thank you, Gigolo Joe. Midget stilts with rocket boosters or sex bots. Okay.
Really?
Well, that's straight to the point.
I don't know if sex bots is a joke or serious.
Either.
You don't know? Because
I think because that's not actually futuristic. Somebody's already.
Oh, look! It was me!
I just want to see Wee Man.
Nobody voted!
I just want to see Wee Man on Jackass flying into walls on those. You see, it's got this hole between its legs. Fucking. Ex Machina, right?
Ex Machina, he's like bragging about how the sentient robot he created is capable of having sex.
Name a candle scent designed specifically for Kim Kardashian. Ego Blaster or Booty Juice?
I would have called it Vapor Snake myself.
Untalented.
I'm depressed.
Which romantic place for abortion clinic?
I mean, it did win.
I didn't get any points.
Someone's not voting. Did someone drop out, or are they just?
No,
these too hard?
I forgot to vote for that one. I was just doing a thing.
Oh.
I did vote for the previous one though.
I did horrible on this round. Next
one. I literally
spoiler alert! The big plot twist in the Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants 7 is that the pants blank were actually cannibalistic, or were Ted McPain's all along.
Who's Ted McPain?
I'm Ted McPain. I can't do it while I'm eating. The awesome knot guy with no pants.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah, him. Oh.
I didn't vote in time, but I got it.
Yeah, I thought that one might be a little specific.
Cannibals. Cannibal dust.
Round two is no more.
Pants eating pants. And Reifiui.
If it, yay! If the pants were trying to eat humans, that's...
If I had my second answer, maybe I would have gotten a chance.
Okay, last lash. Everyone gets the same prompt.
Points are tripled, and everyone gets the same one single prompt this time.
And our prompt is...
The last lash prompt is...
The worst words to say for the opening of a eulogy at a funeral.
Two or five seconds. Four, three, two, one. Oh, it just made it in by the skin of your teeth.
All right, worst words to say. It started a eulogy with Allahu Akbar. No grave diggers. We gotta dig. Sorry. I'm sorry. Ding dong, the witch is dead. Fuck it. If only I could have given her that job.
What? Oh yeah. Oh my god. Because that puts all the blame on you. And
oh, and you have 3 votes. You can vote for something multiple times if you want to. Oh yeah, we in the club now. Okay, no grave diggers. Got one.
We gotta dig, sorry.
Fuck it. Got 2.
Oh, only 2? Damn it. I mean, those are pretty bad words to start a funeral. Just sitting up there, just thinking, Kim not coming up with any kind of answers, you're just like, fuck it.
I don't know, I could hear you saying that at my funeral. Allahu Akbar got 3.
Allahu Akbar.
Ding dong, the witch is dead. Got 5.
Well.
If only I could have given her that job.
Are you kidding, guys?
Got 7.
Why? That answer is garbage. What the hell?
Well, maybe she died from, like, not, I don't know, homelessness?
Because that's an incredibly corny thing to say in real life.
Oh, no one voted for I'm sorry? Like, the murderer is giving the eulogy?
That's too abstract.
Yeah, it's too vague.
I didn't get that.
You don't know what they're saying I'm sorry for.
Oh, Gleam passed me.
I don't get second.
Wow, I bombed.
Screw you and your helicopter, Gleam.
I eat your baby today.
Best answers are better reception for Frankenstein. The prophecy has been fulfilled! Alright. Alright, what else do we got?
Also, I have to be right back. I'll be back in like 2-3 minutes, so.
Okay.
Drawful to.
Well, we can't play the, we played Earwax with your, when your dad was here, but we can't really do that one without,
What is Bidiots?
Weird. I still don't understand how it works myself. It's, you draw things, so it's like Drawful, but there, it's also like Monopoly. And
What is Earwax?
Earwax is combining funny sounds, but we can't play it because you guys would need to hear them.
Ah.
We have not played Bombcore. I don't know what that's like. But it's only 1-4 players, so.
Yeah.
We wouldn't be able
to
do it with all of us.
That doesn't look very appealing anyways.
Yeah. So, our 3 are Fibbage, Quiplash, and Drawful.
And Drawful was fun.
I don't even see Drawful on the list.
No, well, Drawful's a separate executable.
He'll load it in the second.
Here, let's do some Drawful since Jeff hasn't tried that yet. So.
Don't worry if you
Drawful.
Can't.
So horrible.
You don't need to. Everyone's horrible. That's the point.
Really? You guys said that last time, and we had some pretty good drawers.
Okay. What? I wasn't one of them.
I
felt like they were. They said they weren't, but I felt like they were.
Yeah. Okay. I gotta boot that up. So
that's
what?
That's the great thing about art. Everything is subjective and has meaning to anyone.
What was it? Reifiui was the one who just left for a minute.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Did you stop screen sharing, or?
I had to. It's a separate executable that I had to boot up, so I'll have to screen share again. Yeah.
Okay, I'm back.
Hello. We are switching to Drawful, and I gotta screen share again.
Oh, it's my element now.
Oh, Reifiui's the artist. God damn it, Reifiui. That's okay. Being a good artist might actually be like. Oh, it's a Kenpachi owl.
Nice! Oh, man, that's so cool!
That's new. He's got the scar and the
eye
patch
so
and everything.
Cool. Oh, my God! Oh my god, I'm so glad we caught that. I'm using that as some kind of avatar.
The Kenpachi.
That's so fucking cool, bro!
Okay, UADN is the room code.
Holy shit, oh my god, that better be the fucking logo for the video. The fucking... What's it? UADN.
Okay, and then you draw your little thing. And Joshi, who I'm assuming is Reifiui, is the
exactly
guy in charge, so I think everyone's in. You'll be able to start once we're all drawn.
Oh, man. I just realized my internet use is kind of limited in this point, so...
Oh, with your phone?
I'm trying to remember what a certain symbol looks like.
Oh, yeah. I'm actually using, I'm using Jack's computer.
Is that good, Grim?
I can't... Can you erase this at all?
Nope.
Wow. Okay, then.
That's the point. Hello! See, now Jack can hear it. Jack can hear Squidward.
Yeah, I could when I watched the video before.
I couldn't erase it, so I just screwed it out.
What do you think of mine, Grim? You like that?
What is it? Oh, the toilet? It looks like,
It's not a toilet!
Face. Looks like Toadstool on a toilet.
Oh, Toad? Or... He looks like a Goomba.
Toad. Is it Toad or Toadstool?
Oh, okay.
Toad is the little thing with the mushroom head.
What do you think of mine? What, you think you guys get what it's supposed to be?
Could have sworn I thought his name was also... been called Toadstool.
No, Toadstool is the princess.
Oh,
jeez,
Princess
Boz, learn your Mario. Grimmix.
Hey, what do you think of mine? Hey, guys!
We have two people did the toilet.
That's not a toilet!
Oh, what is it? Beanbag?
It's a wheelchair. It's like that, you know, the disabled symbols you see? That's what that's supposed to be.
Should I start now?
It looks like a crescent moon, though. It looks like Sailor Moon in a wheelchair.
I had like a thin line on it. I'm like, no, that doesn't look defined enough, so I added more.
Yes, you can start, Joshi.
I wish I knew you couldn't erase.
That's okay. We've had many a game with someone who has exactly your avatar.
Oh, really?
All right.
Yep, here we go.
Boom! It's Drawful time!
That's creepy.
So you want to draw a picture to the best of your ability that will make people guess the correct title that you're given for that picture. So you want your picture to be accurate to the title. Without using words. No words allowed. It's like Pictionary.
It's kind of weird.
Oh, God.
Thursdays.
I just got a really topical one.
Oh, God.
Draw a picture on your device that would
and it's also going to be hideous.
When you're done, hit send. You'll get points for each player that can correctly guess your title. So, go. Do it.
My problem is, right left-handed, but the mouse is right-handed.
You can't really use the... You could enable lefty mode on your mouse, you just not do
no,
that.
No, I'm pretty much ambidextrous with the mouse. It's just... It's one of those things I write left-handed, so it's one of those things, like... You know, my drawing isn't... I mean, it's not quite the artistic genius that, Grimmix has, you know, with the squibbles and whatnot, but I mean...
Yeah.
I'll learn to deal with it.
Oh.
Me and Jack are on the honor system not to look at each other's.
Yeah, pretty much.
I think I didn't do too bad for once.
Good luck getting this prompt.
God, I'm so bad at drawing. What is it that
you're drawing that's well, important, huh? With this freaking mouse. Let's go. Ding,
ding, 30 seconds ding, left.
Look at my avatar before you think that you're bad at drawing. Ding,
ding, I thought you were the artist. I didn't even see.
I was being sarcastic.
Good enough.
Wait, which one is yours? The pink thing?
Yes, I am. I am the Shashi.
Go.
Boz didn't know who Toad was, though. He probably doesn't know what Yoshi is.
Oh, okay. Why can't we be friends? Why can't we?
So now we all type a title that we think people will think is the real title. So it's not more lying. Oh, okay. Either got too close to the real title or entered something someone else already did.
Well, you know that somebody else has already thought of it, whether the game developers or another player.
It says, you drew this, maybe consult the doctor.
Gay love, hugs, hugfest, collar-elbow tie-up, badly drawn relationship, or hug it out.
That seems like that would be the correct one.
Okay, who picked
I used the wrong letter, I just realized.
Hug it out. Did everyone guess that?
Oh my god.
Good job! Okay. Who was that?
That's what I typed in. That was the actual answer, right?
Yeah. That's the answer. Who drew that?
That was the Goomba. So, Jeff, right? Yeah, I think.
Good job, Jeff.
Is Jeff still on voice?
Yep.
The face he's making, it's just judging you. That's like that Newgrounds face.
Are you watching me?
You know you like it.
Get out of here, donkey.
I don't even know what to say about this.
I entered first and it shows my icon and it just looks like I've given it a thumbs up for the drawing.
Wasn't it the last time we played Drawful, the last thing I drew was also a dude on the toilet?
I don't remember.
In front of a live audience. Ogre on the toilet, Shrek on a toilet, shitty meme, toilet humor, Shrek, or the beginning of a Shrek porno. Hey, you like what you see, donkey?
Oh my god.
You know, Shrek, I gotta say, I always had feelings for you.
And here are your picks.
With this one, I feel like I have to go as literally as possible.
Toilet humor.
There's no way. Yeah, I knew it.
That was Gleams, who was sucking a fox somewhere, that poor fox. Shrek on a toilet. That was Jeff's.
Well, I mean, is it wrong?
Shitty meme.
Thank you!
Point of advice, the game doesn't swear that much, or that heavily. Ogre on the toilet. Yeah, that was it. Only one person guessed it.
I mean, I am
a professional.
Because I forgot that they use, like, they use proper nouns all that often.
They do sometimes. They mentioned Frozen in the previous game.
I put Shrek on the toilet.
Well, I mean, in this game in particular, they don't like to do...
Oh, I forgot to like any. I would have liked Shrek on the toilet.
Shitty meme.
That's pretty good. What is it?
And now, another drawing.
I'm not sure.
Oh.
You drew this. It is done.
Allahu Akbar.
It gets worse every time I look at it.
I don't think anyone's gonna.
What was I doing?
I don't think anyone gets it immediately. I pray God finishes the lower half of my face. Jesus, I think? God giving himself a haircut, angel of peace, crown of thorns, or shoulder devil, no angel.
I have no idea what the fuck this is supposed to be.
I have no clue either, I'm just gonna guess.
I fucked up.
And here are your picks.
Angel of Peace was Grimmix's. Crown of Thorns. Please tell me that was it. Oh, Gleam just got
Damn.
A lot of points. I guess it would have been drawn spikier if that were it.
Yeah, I would have.
God giving himself a haircut.
Somebody actually got it?!
See, I'm a professional, I told you.
It looks like he's using a cross spear.
I was trying to make scissors, but that didn't work out well. Then I realized, that doesn't really look like God. I was trying to make Morgan Freeman, then I didn't realize that.
Then you realized that you couldn't draw. Is that what happened?
Pretty much.
We'll forever have shitty Morgan Freeman.
Put in your titles.
Okay.
I.
All right. I'll be right back.
All right, it's coming.
And here are your choices.
All right, we have small town doctor, home health care, Monopoly, doctor making a house call, did I fire 5 shots or 6, or Dr. Godzilla.
Picks. He's coming, he'll be back. Small town doctor. Everybody picked that one. That was the correct one.
Okay, so that was a sweep.
Yep. That's what I get. I thought he was holding a gun and that was like showing how much ammo he had.
gun that says RX, the RX gun?
I don't have my glasses on.
Do you want your glasses?
No, I'm good.
Okay. This art isn't that detailed.
Oh.
What is it?
Type in.
That's a good question. What the hell is
I don't know.
Oh man, actually.
Goosebumps, a fish evolving legs, No Man's Microsoft Paint, Wingless Bird with a Limp, Free Willy, or Vampire by the Lake.
I'm lost.
I think I know, but you never really know.
Pick something! Let's see what people picked.
Gleam has a drawing tablet. That fucker. A fish evolving legs was my lie.
Pretty clever lie.
It evolved.
Except I saw the duck bill.
It evolved legs on its face. What duck bill?
You see that thing?
That's its tail. Oh, Free Willy was Grimmix.
Jutting out of the side of at the top?
Yeah, that's its tail.
That's a duck bill.
Nah, that's its tail. Goosebumps. Oh, it's a goose. I get it.
Yeah! Yeah, I was like, what could it be? Then I saw dots on like a creature of the air, and I'm like, that's gotta be a goose. I know what's going on.
Okay, that's what you saw.
It's my first failure because that drawing was bad.
I agree.
I got it.
What is it?
Type in a title now.
Oh, I just realized if you don't look at a certain way, it looks much worse. Fuck.
Okay. Out of time. There we go.
If it had tentacles, I think it was something else. Okay.
Demonic possession. Inner tube. Floaty. This belt is killing me. Belt of cursing or cobra belt.
Damn.
Choose something.
Sad day for Gleam. Floaty was Jeff's lie. Or Jeff's title, rather. Inner tube? Why does it have a face?
Some of them do!
Okay. Why does it have an evil face?
I don't know, maybe it's like a 90s inner tube, trying to be edgy.
Okay.
Like a badass, so kids
need more spikes. This belt is killing me was my title.
Fuck! That was a good title. I almost believed it, with the arrow and shit.
Was it demonic? Oh, it was cobra belt?
That's a snake.
Please. Yay!
That's a snake.
I'm no longer winning.
Wait, how is that black?
It's what, huh? It's purple.
Is it?
Yeah, pink and purple.
So I didn't have the choice in my color palette.
First place to second place.
Hey, let's do that drawing.
Okay.
That didn't look pink and purple to me.
Last drawing.
What the fuck am I supposed to draw that?
Everything gets so quiet when people draw.
Yep. I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm just...
I'm trying.
Oh!
Yeah, this is my least favorite of the games.
Yeah? Just because it involves drawing?
No. No, not just...
Because you can't eat the crayons when you're done.
Yeah, exactly.
Life's hard.
Hey, you have 30 seconds to hit send or your drawing will be lost forever. I'm not joking.
Alright, I'm happy with mine. Hello! SpongeBob. Who is it? Yeah, Reifiui has the Squidward.
Check. Let's get to the fun part.
This is gonna suck.
Alright, what is it?
Oh, that don't look good.
Hmm.
It's black to me.
Because you're not wearing your glasses.
I don't want it to affect my color!
Good eulogy title. Violinist. Another shitty Steam horror game. Edward Scissorhands. President Freddy Krueger. Cheerleader Dunk Tank. Or Perfect Merder.
We can get an imperfect murder.
This is a tricky one.
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't know. Oh, I think it's... Yeah, it's probably this.
This is the only one that makes some any sense.
Okay. I don't know. Was it?
Who would have liked Freddy Krueger? Oh wait, that's a proper noun.
Was Jeff's. Was Edward Scissorhands.
Oh, it was Cheerleader Dunk Tank. Why didn't I see it?
Violinist. Was Dale's lie. Dale's title. President Freddy Krueger was the answer.
What?
I'm too good.
What? How do you get? I guess he's president of Japan.
And I just saw. Japan. I don't know. Japan's it was pure luck, honestly.
What about the United States of Japan? All hail Britannia. So no, I guess no one picked Cheerleader Dunk Tank.
That's what I thought. You could successfully convince me with that one.
What is it?
I love that gag.
What the hell?
They found me out, Wilbur. I gotta leave town.
I think I know what this is, but I'm not. How are you supposed to describe it? How?
I think it's called a furry orchard half dragon costume. You just look like the most crestfallen dude.
Oh
ever.
My god, it panned up too. It was like it was a slow pan
from
the
dragon
up.
Legs.
Yeah, after a stomp that startled the main characters, it is panned up to him looking disappointed.
Pin the tail on the donkey. Two people in horse costume. Two guys in a horse costume. Something from my sperm spank bank. The fix is in or Trojan horse.
I'm fucking dumb. Oh my god.
Just pick one. I did, bitch. Whoa, did I say that out loud? That was harsh.
This is really obvious, but that's the only one that makes sense.
Trojan horse was Grimmix's lie. Yeah, that's how they got into Troy. They just stuck...
All two of them!
It wasn't a big wooden thing, they just stuck two guys in a horse costume.
That's how they would do it in Call of Duty, just two people.
Two guys in a horse costume was the correct title. I was happy with that. That was actually pretty easy prompt.
That was spot on.
Did you see what mine was? What I put?
What'd you put? Something from my spank bank?
No.
No?
Just cat face?
Oh, you did? Did you not get it in time?
No, I put two people in horse costume.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, PPL. But the game doesn't use abbreviations, so...
Type in a convincing title now.
I'm gonna tell you this right now, you're not gonna get this.
Oh. Oh. Just... Sounds like an old lady getting, like, poked.
Hurry up, people! Just type something in!
Can you shower already? Crawling in my robes! Shithead cheerleaders. Hothead, Wall of China, my face when I have to find a title for this nonsense.
That's a nice Reddit post, bro.
Pick something. And here are your picks.
Wall of China.
Yeah!
Was Dale's.
Yeah, where's the fucking wall?
Oh, but clearly there's a Chinaman there. Or Brock from Pokemon, one or the other. Please? Oh, we just gave Gleam a lot of points. What was it? Okay.
Thank you.
So he's got like literal shit on his head?
Yes.
Because that's the symptoms of not having showered, is literal shit on your head.
I don't know, I was like looking at the prompt and I'm like, you can't be fucking serious. So I improvise.
I thought it was cheerleaders because the people on the right standing on Jesus' heads.
They're pointing and laughing.
How am I dropping off when I'm keep getting streaks?
What is it?
Enter your titles now.
I feel like we might have gotten this prompt before.
Hey. What?
I like how Dale's little drawing appears, just progressively showing his scribble as it happened.
Yeah.
Drenched in jelly, he has no head, invisible man in a suit, headless salesperson, headless butler, or chocolate fountain.
Probably this one. Is he selling a gun?
Choose something.
Looks like a cigar.
Oh, I saw the plate. Here are your picks. It's headless one here, I'm guessing.
Chocolate fountain. Okay.
Oh. See, that was Gleam's. The chocolate comes out where the head's supposed to be. That's the gimmick.
Drenched in jelly. How intimidating would that be if you saw like a skeleton, but instead of like bleeding blood from his eyes, it was fondue chocolate?
Weirded out.
Invisible man in a suit. Was mine.
Oh, damn, that was good.
I remember previously we had one about the invisible man, I think. And headless butler. I was the only one who guessed it. Okay. I thought they did a pretty good job of that.
I caught it just after I selected the other one, and I'm like, oh wait, he's got the plate. Of course it's headless butler.
Yeah. Because
that's a really simple prompt.
You guys suck.
What is it?
Put in your titles.
Oh my god, it is terrifying.
I'm not even sure what it is.
It's not going to be this because the game doesn't swear, but it looks like shit being flung at something.
I know, I have legitimately no idea what the fuck this is supposed to be.
Time is up.
Time is up. Time is up.
Meatball rolling off my spaghetti. Meteor hitting the earth. Miracle. Obscure reference that I don't get. Yoshi egg throwing, or do eggs poop?
Miracle.
On top of spaghetti, all covered with cheese.
Is that really what that's gonna fucking be?
I lost my poor meatball.
Pick one.
That was a stupid song!
When somebody sneezed. Well, they didn't spell spaghetti right, so.
Oh. Yeah.
That was kind of a giveaway. Nice try, Gleam.
I give up.
Yoshi egg throwing.
Oh, I'm glad
a little specific.
I clicked the wrong thing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, damn it! I got points by accident.
I did look at that and think it was a Yoshi egg at first, but. I don't think the game would be that specific. Meteor hitting the Earth. The shitty, shitty Earth. Oh
my god!
Jeff got us.
Got melancholia,
son.
Got
bamboozled.
What is it? A meteor's a miracle? Wait, I'm confused.
What's the miracle? I know what's going on!
There's fucking
what?
Sperm going to the egg.
That doesn't look like a sperm.
It doesn't look like sperm. That doesn't. What the fuck? That's,
it looks
that's
like
how nobody
lines,
fucking
though.
Draws sperm. In no
you gotta draw
nowhere.
A circle with a squiggle on it. What is it?
Yes!
Sinosuke afraid of a camera. Oh. Okay, what is it? Busted, getting too close at the batting cages, camera shy, cameraman, king of filmmaking, or selfie stick.
Remember what? When that woman invented the selfie stick and people were calling her an idiot? That was the hindsight of
what came out first, this game or the selfie stick?
The selfie stick came out first.
I have no idea.
Hello.
Okay.
And out of time.
Your picks. I didn't make a choice. I forgot to make a choice. I was
busted. Was Jack's lie? Jack's title. Cameraman was.
Oh.
Gleams. Camera shy. Yay!
I would have also bought batting cages.
It looked like it's saying crack.
It's a shame in being camera shy.
It was click.
It can always be a voice.
Oh, okay.
In a video
it looks
game.
Like an R. I saw crack and thought maybe it was some guy getting hit by a baseball.
So it is.
And Jeff wins by 500 points. Oh, I was close. Why is the tall midget on a toilet?
Hold on a second, guys.
Okay. And Reifiui wins in the likes.
Yay.
Okay, what else do what was in Jackbox 1? It was just previous versions of the same games mostly. Right?
Yeah, yeah. Like
Fibbage 1 and Drawful 1.
Yeah. This is just stuff we've seen before.
Yeah. At least we got the Kenpachi owl.
Yeah, that was cool.
Okay, I'm back.
All right, so we got some of that done.
Let's
know.
Do Fibbage again.
You want to do Fibbage
again?
Oh,
let's do Fibbage again.
All
that
right,
cool.
Yes.
We'll do Fibbage again. Food?
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, screen share.
Jeff, you there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys are a quiet bunch.
Yeah, it's... Oh, dude, we should play Town of Salem again soon.
Hell yeah, that would be really fun too.
I would be up for it.
And the, what's the other one?
Cards Against Humanity?
The really raunchy one, yeah.
Yeah.
Were you there the last time we played when I had a. Well, I guess you wouldn't. We made a custom Cards Against Humanity set for all the, like, the gang's in jokes, but I guess you haven't been around for a lot of them, so I don't know how much that would.
Fibbage too.
Yeah, not lately.
Dude, we should just. Somebody should just compile. Like, all a list of all the, like, Fibbage / Quiplash answers, just make a Cards Against Humanity set based on them.
Yeah. Your room code is Olodge. OLOJ.
The Oregon Lodge. Oh man, that was nearly as annoying as I would have hoped it was. The ring on the phone.
Oh.
What?
It changed my name.
It's still the same name. What was your name before?
Hold on, let me see if I can back
Toilet
out.
Xelrog.
Well, you can't back out, dude.
No, I just closed the tab. What did that do?
It backed out. It didn't back you out because you're still... you're gonna need to rehost now.
Okay, I'm back in.
But you're...
Yeah, it still didn't change my name.
Yeah. What's your name?
I changed my name to Asian Xelrog with a gong.
Oh. Well, what is it now?
Well, now it's Toilet Xelrog, is it showing up?
Oh, okay.
Should I? Yeah, you can go ahead and start, Gleam. Sorry. Everyone's here.
Trivia game.
Hi, I'm your host,
dude, you can run like your own trivia. Like, forgetting your
names. I mean, anyone can make their own card set. You're welcome to do so, too.
Well, I mean, for this, just like, you have, like, a bunch of celebrities face each other against these games. That would be cool.
Like, Celebrity Squares, but with the Jackbox set?
Yes. I wish I had the influence to make celebrities do this kind of thing.
Yeah.
This is round one, and that means you get 500 points for everyone you fool with your made-up...
All right, round one.
You get 1,000 for finding the truth.
Still explaining.
And you've got a defibrillator. Use
defibrillator.
One lie and the truth. And just one
what does it do, by the way?
It takes all the answers on the board, and it just reduces them to
Jack's
two.
Turn.
Okay, here's your first question.
In the movie The Hangover, ancient Romans who got too drunk and woke up with a hangover would often attempt a strange cure. They'd eat a deep fried blank.
Now, use your device to enter a bluff that you think will fool the other players into thinking it's true. If you can't think of anything in time, use the lie for me button for half the points. Do it now.
Well, it's not really. Yeah. Deep frying shit's an actual like hangover cure though, so I'm wondering what the actual.
There's no actual. They'd eat a deep fried body of Christ. They'd eat a deep fried pig heart, a deep fried boar penis, a deep fried squid, deep fried canary, deep fried snail, or deep fried fish. A lot of just animals.
Well, I mean, there's only, fry some plants? The Romans didn't know how to do that yet.
Mm-hmm.
Fried asparagus.
Pig heart was...
Fry a whole pig's heart, what the
Grimmix is lie.
What the is this? Like, this...
Nice lie there, you liar, you.
Fry a whole turkey.
A deep-fried snail.
Oh.
Was Gleams.
Nobody got it. It was probably squid then.
That was a great
could have been anything. Could have been a canary. I'm guessing canary.
Well, you guys
yep.
Know it.
Okay, that is strange.
That's a
fucking.
They were in Rome.
You eat a fucking songbird.
And that's it. Nobody else's lives got picked.
Not just a songbird, but a deep fried songbird.
Now, what do you think it sounds like while it's being fried?
I would tell you, but I don't want to wake up my family.
Alright, so Gleam and Grimmix, the only ones who got points thus far. At least someone liked the deep fried body of Christ.
All right,
choose a word.
King.
Okay, here's the question.
King Charles the 14th of Sweden actually had a tattoo on his arm that read, surprisingly, blank.
Surprisingly, blank. Write your lies now.
I want to do one that's funny, but not... no one would guess it, so I have to go for something that would actually trick people.
Yeah, same thing. I was gonna put like pink or cutie.
I have no idea for a real answer.
Thug life. I wanted to make like he had like a Crips or Bloods tattoo joke.
Death to Kings.
USA, the king, baby. Burn after death. Highness, PM me your nudes. Or death to the queen.
Death to the queen. Fuck, we know who the killer is! He's striking on his body!
Okay, what did everyone pick?
Death to the... Aw.
No.
That would be strange.
That's strange, but that's like...
Burn after death was also, well, it would have been on a second guess, was
Jack. Well, because plague. So always got to be careful of that shit.
Highness.
Why the fuck would a king have highness? I don't know, medieval jokes are weird.
USA. Was Gleams.
A Swedish kid.
It could be a coincidence.
It's PM.
Then again, I don't know when this king reigned. Death to kings. Okay.
Yeah, cause that sounds like the kind of shit like a king would put on his body. Like, of course he would write death to kings. It's ironic. People like that. People fall for that shit. Like, death to kings.
Maybe he meant to take it to his grave, in which case people would like first see it at his funeral and be like really meaningful.
Yeah, he'd
dude seem like a martyr.
Dude was trying to be deep.
Choose a word, Reifiui.
Reifiui. Yeah, I get it.
Oh, hey, we got a bleacher. Yeah. Spain.
Okay, here's the question.
The mayor of Ador, Spain, recently instituted a daily blank for the entire town.
A daily blank for the entire town. Type in your lies now.
Wow, everybody's just coming up with a lot of stuff immediately.
Yeah, we're...
How? I don't know.
We're quick on this.
How did you find something so quickly?
If you can't think of anything, hit lie for me.
Just write Donald Trump. No, that doesn't work anymore, but you confirmed that last time.
Yeah. I was gonna put orgy.
I'd like that. A daily curfew for the entire town, a daily traffic ban, a daily orgy, a daily poker tournament, a daily bath, a daily baptism, or a daily nap time for the entire town.
The fuck's the point of a daily baptism? You do it once!
Well, that's why it's strange.
A daily poker tournament? That would get old really quick. Oh, it's gotta be. What is this? Yep, it's that one.
Would you live in a town that had a daily orgy law?
Like, if it was optional.
Oh my god.
Every single person got it.
Did everybody use the defibrillator?
I know, I didn't. Did you?
No.
I didn't either.
Actually, yes, I did.
Sorry. I just remembered somewhere that I heard that, like, Spain liked naps for some reason, so I don't know.
They think it, like, it'll increase your daily productivity if you're allowed to nap.
Where are you at again, Reifiui? France?
What did you say?
Where are you at again?
Yeah, I'm French.
Okay.
Oh.
Popsioslav was Polish, I think. We need a couple of Europeans.
Expanding 4C Studios International.
Now it's round two, where all point values are doubled.
Alright, round two.
And remember to use your defibrillator if you need a little jolt of hope. Use it in round two or lose it.
Okay, right, choose a word, Dale. Tequila shrapnel. That sounds scary.
That's a weekend you don't wake up from.
Graffiti.
Okay, here's the question.
In 2015, Los Angeles police were on the lookout for a graffiti artist who, of all things, had sprayed graffiti all over a blank.
Input your lies now.
Oh my god, I can't do this. I can't.
I came up with two very quickly.
I don't.
Reifiui has the art advantage, but not the improv. Okay. All over a police horse, all over a sleeping homeless man, all over a police car, a Toyota Prius, a Walmart, a bridge, or a cop car.
Oh, a police car or a cop car, or a police horse.
Police car?
It's 2015, so probably not a police horse, but you never know.
They still use those in New York.
Yeah, you don't spray paint a Prius, you just write LOL on it. Let's see what everybody Walmart, everybody spray paints Walmart.
Bridge. Police car? Oh, it was cop car, wasn't it? God
you
damn
got wrecked.
It.
Who's probably police horse.
Is that you, Jock?
That's what? Me.
Are you Jock? Oh, who? Okay, no. Jeff.
Cop Read car. The name.
No, that was Gleams.
Really?
It was a sleeping homeless person.
Tell me it was the horse.
It was a horse, okay.
Oh my god. Like, I'm more shocked that there's still police horse.
I am sad that no one picked the sleeping homeless man. I think that's a hilarious scene to imagine.
We were too obsessed around cops.
Because, you know, at the end of you say about police, you gotta have sex with them.
Indeed. Okay, at least people liked it. Choose a word, Jeff. Huff. Oh, McKinley! It comes back!
McKinley!
The comeback.
Oh, snap! Teddy Roosevelt once burned President McKinley by saying he had no more backbone than a blank.
No more backbone than a blank. Enter your lies now.
Oh, we all did it at the same time.
No more backbone than a pepper shaker. No more backbone than a slug, than a chocolate eclair, than an octopus, than a frankfurter, than a jellyfish, or than a worm.
Oh my god, these are all really good.
No one eclair. I'm hungry.
I think that was too obvious, fuck.
My first thought was to put a Negro, but I thought that might be a little too far.
Yeah, this that might is a little too far. I don't know why you decided to mention this.
Very topical for the time, though.
What? Okay, oh. Teddy Roosevelt. Okay.
That was after slavery, wasn't it?
Oh my god.
Yes.
Yeah, I knew it was too obvious. Fuck.
McKinley was around the turn of the century. He got assassinated in 1901.
I don't know my presidents. Jellyfish. Oh, that's Grimmixes.
Wow.
Oh, wait, what?
So, Worm? No, Worm wasn't it. And it was Jack's lie.
They, yeah, I mean, famously have no bones. Believe it or not, it was also... Wait, what?
Three people. That was my lie.
What the fuck? What is your obsession with jellyfishes?
Three of us said jellyfish.
What the fuck?
I like Gowry. Gowry was pretty cool.
It looks like everything else.
Should have followed our gut. It was
a total what?
I thought that Reefy put it as like a French joke, a chocolate éclair. I'm not kidding. I'm serious. I thought that.
I can see it.
Like I think my brain completely ignored this answer altogether because it was just too dumb.
Wow, I am.
I didn't
sucking.
Even consider it.
Jellyfish.
What do you think I'm
Choose
doing
a word,
right now?
Gleam. Nipple. Tyson. Tyson nipple. Baby nipple.
Tyson, please choose.
Baby nipple auction. This is like a good improv game, just like find its prompts. In early 2015, a man in Muskogee, Oklahoma lost his nipple when blank.
Oh my god!
Oklahoma. Ugh.
When he just woke up without it, when he got it caught in his car door, when he was having sex, when his dog ate it, when farming, when it got stuck on a cold flagpole, when a zebra bit it off.
Oh my god. The answer I put down is even my original answer, because I was... Oh man, I put... I'll say the answer I tried to put down, but couldn't because it was too long.
I'm sure I just picked the worst answer, but fuck it.
There are a lot of good ones here. Okay, what did everyone pick? Or a lot of funny ones, at least. He got it caught in his car door.
Told you I picked the worst one.
Long
shirtless driving is drunk driving.
At least you got one. I screwed up, I didn't even do one.
It got stuck on a cold flagpole. That was theirs. Good answer, though. A zebra bit it off.
That's oddly...
Exactly. It's specific enough to be it.
Yeah.
Why is there a zebra? Why?
Exotic pets were more prominent than you might think.
Zoo.
I used to live across from a dude who kept two cougars. Just in cages in his backyard.
That lucky bastard.
Oh, the cat.
Was he able to keep those?
Okay.
Yes, the cat.
Hey, honey, time to move.
Two cougars and two large cats.
All in cages. That makes sense.
No, we kept the cats
inside.
And
I still didn't drop a rank.
Final fibbage.
This is the final fibbage. 1 point left for all the marbles, and everything is worth.
Can you guys hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, here is your final fibbage question.
Name of the actual 1970s shampoo that was enriched with beer. Okay, gotta come up with a punny product name.
Oh, no.
Your English puns will be tested, Reifiui.
I can't do names of things.
I wasn't alive then.
Also, I don't even know, like, typical shampoo names. I'm a disadvantage. Oh my god.
I don't wash my hair.
I hate this so much.
Oh, I don't have hair.
Headwiser, Hopper Harvest, Body on Tap, Beer Shrillance, Beer Naked, Suds, or Goes to Your Head.
There's a guy from a show who, like, wanted to be a stripper, and he said that, I'll go by Nick Naked.
What? Oh, right, yeah, like, his name.
Yeah. Then, like... See what everybody selected. Oh, of course.
Beer Naked was Gleam's lie. Suds. Oh, whose was that? That was Jeff's. Good title. Headwiser was Jack's.
Wow, that was some major league bluffing right there.
And
something you might be interested
in. It was Body on Tap.
Damn it. That was kind of an anticlimax.
It's not even a good title.
Did people at least get Beer Shrillance?
No.
Sheer Brilliance?
Oh. That... Because when people think of a good product, they don't think of the word shrill.
Yeah. Implying that beer shampoo is a good product. And Jeff wins.
Touché.
I cry.
And who gets the thumbs cup?
Not me.
Four-way tie. Oh. Okay, so
I won something in my life.
You sure are a number four, Reifiui.
And so it ends. There ends the story of Fibbage 2.
Alright.
Our heroes go home and enjoy the finest in winery.
We got a little time left. We can do one more. You guys want Fibbage or Quiplash?
Quiplash.
Quiplash is so fun.
Yeah, we'll do one more Quiplash and then we'll end it.
Who is
very
hitting?
Angry with their keyboard.
Sorry.
There we go.
XYUM, okay. Right?
How many what now?
Oh, I gotta wait for a new code.
Yes.
By the way, the answer I was trying to write for how the man lost his nipple was a Japanese businessman with a katana cut it off.
Oh, okay.
But it was too long.
A horrible Bankai training accident. OMVU. I envy you.
What's the
That would be a kind of self-loathing, like, license plate. I envy you. OMVU is the code.
On vous.
Alright.
I'm here, everybody!
Alright, I think... Okay, that's all of us. Go ahead and... Boz, or Dale, Grimmix person.
And so begins... the quippening.
I'm like a parent who goes through all of their children's names from the beginning before remembering the last one. John, I mean Dave, I mean Harold.
Yeah.
He's just always Boz, I mean Grim, I mean Dale.
I only had that problem. I only, like... sorry, I was
talking to my friend. Boz, I mean Grim, I mean Dale. Sounds like you're coming down with Alzheimer's.
you just have you have one daughter, right?
Yes.
Grim? Okay. On your device. Answer them any way you want.
Each answer will go up against someone else's answer. Hey, my parents call me my name, my brother's name, they call me my sister's name, my cousin's name, it doesn't matter.
Interestingly, his name was Wendy.
Pretty much.
Okay, round one. 90 seconds, two prompts. Jack got a good prompt.
That worries the hell out of me.
I really, really hope this gets some... Oh no. What happened? There we go. Okay, good. It's still here. I really, really hope this gets some laughs out of people. That I... Hey, I want to have some points this time.
Ten seconds.
7, 6.
I could have done better on that second
my
one.
My answers were mediocre.
Yeah, I'm not happy with mine.
My second one was garbage.
Something Godzilla does when he's drunk.
Whoa, what does he do?
What you see in every Godzilla movie, or confesses that his dad was beating him.
Oh god!
That's so bad. I wasn't always a monster.
You know, Godzilla had a son, and he did kind of treat him like shit.
The tragic backstory of Godzilla.
Tragic backstory of Godzilla.
Fortunately,
was
you
a
can't
harmless
hear
creature,
the dad's
and they
story
because
he's breathing fire on everything.
Yay! Yeah, he's just drunk in every Godzilla movie. That's what plot. That's what the movie plot is. That's why he's destroying shit.
Yeah.
Are you degenerate, Jay?
Yep.
Mr. Jay. So apparently Suicide Squad sucks.
Tell me about it. That's what I heard people, like, audiences enjoyed it. So, you know what?
Yeah.
It's like, if it's not meant for critics, whatever.
The worst shape for an animal cracker.
Oh, well, do tell.
Turd emojis or dog.
Those exist! Like, one of the animal crackers has to be a dog!
I mean, they're circus animals, so...
Dog's a circus animal. Dog tricks.
I guess.
It's like, oh, you're advocating... Dog's not that bad, because...
I was thinking, like, a something penis-shaped, but I couldn't think of any animal like that.
Thank you!
I just picked it because it was an animal. I wanted to guess Harambe for the answer, but I didn't. I would have voted for that.
I wouldn't have.
A weird thing to find in your grandparents' bedside table. A ball gag and crotchless panties.
Oh, nice.
Or vibrator. One of those is slightly tamer than the other. The other drawer just has Viagra. Oh, I guess Moro messaged that he was able to join. Yeah, he just got here, but yeah, we're just about done. We're just about ending the stream, unfortunately, Moro. A realistic echidna would be better. Okay, I guess. A pony fuck toy.
Pony fuck toy.
Those exist.
I know they do.
Yeah, I know. Somebody told me there's an inflatable sheep.
Like Dinger, Grand Salami, and Jack, come up with a new slang term for a home run in baseball.
What?
Orbital assault, or whip it out. Yo, man, he just gotta whip it out!
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Alternatively, you can imagine Spock just seeing a baseball on radar approaching the ship.
Orbital assault is like the thing they would create, the extreme sport they would create for all those sci-fi movies in the 90s.
Yeah, I wasn't happy with that answer. Oh, Moro's in the audience. Good to know.
So we whip it out.
Excuse me while I whip this out. I think it was off stream. Someone said that voice sounded like the bad guy from VeggieTales.
Oh, coming up next, there was a bad guy.
Yes, he was a pickle. Where missing socks go. In cheese factories, or the underwear gnomes kidnap them.
Not steal. Kidnap! Why are you doing this? I don't know. Because we'll profit later.
Step 3. Profit! I would have said Narnia. Mr. Tumnus steals them for warmth.
Sorry.
Moro says, he's whipping it out. Wow, the audience goes wild. This is insane.
Yeah.
The worst Vegas casino. Blank Palace. Sodom and Gomorrah Palace. Fudge Dumpster Palace. I don't know. Wouldn't Sodom and Gomorrah Palace be the best casino?
No. Look at how the first part's spelled.
Okay, I guess Sodom and Gomorrah. That's a very specific joke.
It was a pun. I was like, I'll take
combining some very obscure things. Well, I mean, Saddam Hussein isn't that obscure, but
I got old. Thank you, audience.
Maybe Morrison knows what Sodom and Gomorrah is. Maybe. Possibly.
That's a biblical reference!
Yeah, it is. It's an obscure one, though.
Yeah, it's S-O-D-O-M, isn't it?
And Sodom. Also One Piece characters.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, that was it? Oh, that was just the first round.
Okay. Oh, boy.
Grimmix in a dominating lead, like twice as many points as second place.
Yeah, we gotta fix that.
Round two.
We gotta fix that. Haters gonna hate.
What was the answer you were so proud of, Jack? Or the prompt?
That one. That one.
Sodom and Gomorrah. Saddam and Gomorrah. I'm so tempted. There's something I could, I could appeal to someone for this one, but no one else would get it.
I think these answers were slightly better.
Yeah.
Alright, there we go.
I feel okay about mine. 28 seconds.
I feel interested about mine. See how that'll work.
I keep trying to just think, like, outside of the box, but after that, I just say fuck it.
No, you need to keep the box, because when you read some of them, then you have to puke in it. It just makes it easier.
If anyone missed the start of the stream, by the way, Jack's doped up on pain meds.
Yeah, but if I'm outside of the box, I can puke in it without...
Jesus' real last words.
I'm doped up on
God.
Doped smite up on them, they know exactly what they do. Or uncontrollable weeping.
Oh, then I'm
Jack,
so uncontrollable!
Jack, if it makes you feel any better, I'm doped up on a sleeping pill, so we're in even ground.
Yeah,
but Boz always sounds like he's doped up on sleeping pills.
You're the chillest member of the crew, Boz.
Jack's usually, like, rambunctious.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm deep in I'm zen right now.
I'm just
I've always said Dale has a midnight radio voice.
Yeah, I can buy it.
Or a serial killer voice, one of the two.
Well, one person didn't vote!
Yeah. Nippleless Katana. Is that you?
What?
Someone named themselves Nippleless Katana. They misspelled Katana, but I think they were referencing your salesman joke.
Oh yeah, that's right. Thank you for that.
A horrible pickup line.
Here we go.
Oh, I know. That's a classic.
You know, I'm on Xelrog's stream. Get in the fucking car or I'll kill you. Your hair smells nicker when you're awake.
Oh my god! That was a close Freudian slip, dude. It was so close.
I'm gonna make my vote because they both have grammatical errors, so whatever. A lot of people aren't voting.
Where is everybody?
I voted.
Quiplashed. That was what I was proud of.
Is Reifiui opt out?
Wait, I didn't vote for this? I thought I did.
What? I don't know, did you? I didn't see who
was voting.
The name of a board game for players age 70 and older. Who also happen to own crotchless panties. Where's my teeth?
Oh, fuck.
Le epic memes.
Somebody actually, like, went around Europe, like, posting, like, taking posters, like, tired of the same old bullshit politics, having a party you can trust, and putting down, like, the generic Lemon Party, like, join the Lemon Party today, putting the website to Lemon Party down there.
I don't know, I was caught. I didn't really want to vote for either one.
Well, because both of them are easy in their own right. One, you're making just an old person joke. The other, you're referencing a meme. But they're both pretty funny.
See, I don't know the meme.
Why should you never turn your back on a penguin?
Lemon Party is a site where it's just a bunch of old people having sex. Like,
I've seen Madagascar, or because you're Batman.
The second one sounds like a joke.
It's just random. I don't see why.
Yeah, it seems just...
Oh, Penguin, random. Batman, and Penguin?
Yeah, Penguin was a villain in Batman.
That's like a really, like, loose...
I guess it makes sense when you explain it. I wanted I knew Morrowsaw would be... I knew Morrowsaw would like it, but no one else would get it. I was considering putting Doot. Which is a this Gaia thing.
Dude.
Next is... Dude, this game is awesome. A good sign that you've drunk too much. A good sign that you've drunk too much Mountain Dew. I miss Seuss. You answering this prompt with dank maymays, or Xboxes materialize in front of you. Please drink your confirmation can of Mountain Dew to initiate system. People made a lot of Reddit posts of like the future of Xbox and shit like that.
Yeah. I just thought it. Like, you take a person's blood, you replace it all with, like, Mountain Dew, and then they're just, like, surfboarded off the walls and shit.
I think that would turn someone into Guy Fieri.
What?
Having Mountain Dew blood?
I think they would become masters of parkour.
If any human had that, I think it would be him.
Next one. Next one.
Something that should never be homemade. Condoms. Or back hair toupee.
Both are pretty bad. What the fuck could a homemade condom be?
A Milky Way wrapper.
And cellophane.
Here, I'm just gonna wrap my dick in this.
I've got paper towels.
When I was in high school, somebody asked one of the kids
about cellophane on a tube sock.
A literal balloon. Plastic wrap.
Hey,
he asked somebody's mother if he could have some cellophane, and she says, why can't you just buy condoms?
Yeah. Every store has a condom these days.
Yeah.
Oh, and there is that round. Round two. Fire up
the scoreboard. All right, where are we at? How far did Grimmix fall? Still in a dominate. Okay, no. Gleam caught up.
I'm still a loser.
Round three, the last lash. The last lash. Point values are triple, and you'll all be answering the same prompt this time. Your prompt is... Okay. A weird photo to keep in your wallet. Photo to keep in your wallet.
All right, I got mine in.
Hmm.
14, 13, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Everybody's in. All right, how's this gonna end?
Somebody else's dick pic. Your penis erect. Your mother naked. A picture of your fridge, your best friend's mom, or a picture of Jacob Sartorius.
Who?
Hmm.
Who is Jacob Sartorius?
I don't think anyone knows.
I've never heard of him.
Maybe he's French.
You have Google.
In 10 seconds.
Google is pretty fast.
Jack, jangling his keys.
I'm sorry, I'm just... The noise is soothing to me.
Thank you, I guess. Audience members.
Your penis. You're right.
It's a good replacement for pickup lines.
Yeah.
Your best friend's mom got 3.
What we got next? Oh, yeah, I got some answers. Oh, is it only... five?
Yep, that's 5.
Cool. Nice. I'm happy with that.
Somebody else's dick pic got 6 with the audience.
I mean, that's a pretty,
And a picture of your fridge was apparently the winner with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So it's tied. A picture of your fridge. Well, whenever you want to remind yourself to eat. And one didn't get chosen.
No one picked Jacob Sartorius.
That's the end. Let's see the final scoreboard.
Okay, so I'm thinking Boz Gidale won. Because he was one of the top ones, I think.
Yeah,
yep.
He won.
Yeah!
Him and Gleam taking the lead. Timmy Turner wins.
Yep. Jeez.
A ball gag and crotchless panties was the top answer. And the underwear gnomes.
So I had some pretty decent answers that time.
All Grimmix top answers. Your hair smells knicker.
Yeah.
You really caught up on that typo.
Yeah, I don't miss typos. But yeah, all the top answers were Grimmix. They were good answers, though.
Do you ever see, what was the movie, Dodgeball?
Yes, I have.
When they show up with the outfits?
Yeah, I think I remember.
The stuff gets sent to the wrong place.
Oh,
so they have
yeah.
to go out in the Dominatrix outfits.
Oh, yeah, they have to wear the leather daddy stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, there's an optional content filter, guys.
Oh.
All right. Yeah, we've been going for a while. I think we're done, right?
Yeah, we're done.
Yeah, right. More than 2 hours.
Thanks for playing, guys. Fun having you.
Thanks for inviting me.
And,
same.
See y'all next time.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.